Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yesh Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 26th of August. India's coronavirus cases top 3.2 million, recovery rate over 76%. Pakistan urges Taliban to start peace talks with Afghan government. And COVID-19 restrictions in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley to continue until September 2. And now for all the details. The coronavirus situation in India continues to be grim, with the total cases crossing 3.2 million mark. Recoveries also saw further increase, with 63,173 COVID-19 patients being cured between Tuesday and Wednesday morning, which has taken the country's recovery rate to 76.29%. Meanwhile, with the marginal increase in coronavirus cases in Delhi over the past few days, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal said on Wednesday that testing rates in national capital would be doubled as precautionary measure.
India recorded more than 60,000 cases of COVID-19 for the eighth day in a row on Wednesday, as total cases crossed 3.2 million, including 707,267 active cases. The total number of fatalities from the infection has risen to 59,449. As India's national capital also recorded a spike in the number of new cases of the coronavirus disease, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal said on Wednesday that the state government will double the testing for COVID-19 infection in the region. Delhi recorded 1,544 new COVID-19 cases on Tuesday, its highest single-day spike in August, to take the total number of cases in the city past 164,000.
आज की डेट में टेस्ट्स लगभग 20,000 टेस्ट पर डे होते हैं. इसको हम एक हफ्ते के अंदर 40,000 टेस्ट्स पर डे करेंगे. हमारी स्ट्रेटजी यही रहेगी जो पहले थी. टेस्ट एंड आइसोलेट, टेस्ट एंड आइसोलेट.
Meanwhile, one of the world's richest temples, Sri Padmanabh Swami Temple in southern Thiruvananthapuram city, opened on Wednesday after being closed for 5 months due to the coronavirus pandemic. The temple that had been closed since March 21st due to the rising cases of coronavirus opened for devotees for a limited period of time in the morning and evening to prevent crowding. While some devotees registered online a day prior to the reopening to visit the temple and offer prayers, few others were seen praying from outside the temple.
കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് ഭഗവാനെ ദർശനം നടത്തിയപ്പോൾ മനസ്സിന് നല്ലൊരു സന്തോഷം ഉണ്ടായി. അതോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ ഈ മഹാമാരി ഈ ലോകത്തു നിന്ന് തന്നെ മാറണമെന്ന് ഭഗവാനോട് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചു. എല്ലാവർക്കും നല്ലത് വരണമെന്ന്, എല്ലാ ഭക്തജനങ്ങൾക്കും എല്ലാ
With the number of active cases in Kerala reaching 21,296, authorities are allowing only 35 devotees at a time inside the temple to curb spread of the deadly disease.
Heavy downpour increased the water level of River Ganga on Wednesday, leading to flood-like situation in several Indian states where the river flows. Meanwhile, the weather department issued warnings that eastern parts of Odisha were likely to get heavy rain till Thursday, along with possible flash floods, landslides and waterlogging.
Locals and devotees in Varanasi in India's northern Uttar Pradesh state expressed worry after torrential rains led to an increase in the water level of River Ganga that flows through the temple town on Wednesday. The usual activities at the riverbank were also affected, with people shifting to higher places amid rising water level, which most of all hit the cremation process, for which people travel to Varanasi from far-flung areas. Temple priests sitting on makeshift arrangements outside temples said the inflow of devotees and tourists was already hit due to the coronavirus pandemic.
जलस्तर गंगा जी का बढ़ा हुआ है, 5-6 चौकियां आगे बढ़ी हैं और निरंतर पानी बढ़ी रहा है। अब जगह सीमित होता चला जा रहा है, यात्रियों का आवागमन भी लॉकडाउन को लेकर कम हो गया है, कुछ भी नहीं है, यहाँ का कार्यक्रम सब बंद है।
Meanwhile, राम गंगा, a tributary of the river Ganga, also flowed close to the danger mark in Moradabad in Uttar Pradesh, with incessant rain continuing to lash the plains, leading to waterlogging in most parts of the city. Similar scenes were witnessed in India's eastern Odisha state, where a red alert was sounded for several districts. The weather department said with the formation of a new low pressure area over North Bay of Bengal, most parts of Odisha are likely to get heavy rain till Thursday, along with possible flash floods, landslides and waterlogging.
Pakistan on Tuesday urged the Taliban to start talks with the Afghan government soon to end decades of conflict, telling visiting officials of the group that an intra-Afghan dialogue could help ensure regional stability. Afghanistan's peace process has stalled over disagreements on a prisoner exchange.
Pakistan urged the Taliban on Tuesday to start talks with the Afghan government soon to end decades of conflict, telling visiting officials of the group that an intra-Afghan dialogue could help ensure regional stability. The meeting between Pakistan's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi and a Taliban team led by the head of the group's political office, Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar, comes as Afghanistan's peace process has stalled over disagreements on a prisoner exchange. Talks between the Taliban and the Afghan government were to be held in Doha following completion of the prisoner exchange. The completion of the swap has been delayed by disagreements between the Taliban and the Afghan government.
कि अक्टूबर 2019 से लेकर अब तक क्या पेशरफ्त हुई है, कहां कामयाबियां हासिल हुई हैं और अभी भी अगर कोई पेचीदगियां हैं तो वो क्या हैं और उनका हल कैसे निकल सकता है। हमने
देयर आर ऑल्सो कंसर्न्स ओवर राइजिंग वायलेंस इन अफगानिस्तान व्हिच डिप्लोमेट्स से इज सैपिंग ट्रस्ट नीडेड फॉर द टॉक्स। The insurgent group has so far rejected implementing a ceasefire before the talks start.
Heavy monsoon rain lashed Pakistan's southern city of Karachi, flooding streets and causing chaos on Tuesday. Many low-lying areas have been submerged, forcing the provincial government to declare a rain emergency.
Heavy rains continued for the second day in Pakistan's Karachi city on Tuesday, wreaking havoc on the metropolis, flooding roads and submerging many low-lying areas. Vehicles driving through the water stalled and drivers were seen pushing them through the water. Rescue workers helped people stuck in homes that had become inundated, bringing them to safety on inflatable boats.
Karachi शहर के अंदर बहुत तेज बारिश हुई है, सारा कारोबार धर्म भरम हो गया, पानी बहुत है जगह जगह पर और सारी गाड़ियां बंद हो गई हैं, अभी सारा ट्रैफिक वगैरह सब जाम है।
The meteorological department has issued urban flooding warnings in Sindh province. At least 8 people were killed in Karachi after a spell of monsoon rain hit the city last month.
बारिश में काम पे जा रहा था, जरा देख के चले, बारिश हो चुकी थी, रोडों में पानी इतना भर चुका था, गाड़ियां वगैरह बंद हो चुकी थी पानी के अंदर, देख के अभी मजबूरी की वजह से काम पे नहीं जा सकता, वापस जा रहा हूं घर में।
Monsoon rains have killed at least 90 people and damaged at least 1,000 homes across Pakistan, according to the country's National Disaster Management Agency. The weather department said that Karachi had received 345 mm of rainfall so far in August, breaking the previous record of 298 mm reported in August 1984.
Moving on, a massive protest rally was held recently in Dandiyal city of Pakistan-administered Kashmir against frequent load shedding and human rights violations committed by Pakistan in the illegally occupied region. The protesters accused Islamabad of regular power cuts, high tariffs, corruption and police brutality against civil rights campaigners. The protesters said that the electricity produced from the resources of Pakistan-administered Kashmir should be given to them only and not to Pakistani provinces. They also condemned the arrest and torture of Tanveer Ahmed, a journalist and activist, after he removed Pakistan's flag from a popular public place in the region on August 21st. In news from Nepal, Local authorities of Nepal's Kathmandu, Lalitpur and Bhaktapur districts have decided to extend the ongoing prohibitory orders by a week in Kathmandu Valley until 2nd of September amid the rise in coronavirus cases. Kathmandu Valley has been under prohibitory orders barring public mobility and vehicular movements since August 19 midnight.
The ongoing prohibitory order in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley to curb the spread of coronavirus has been extended further till the midnight of September 2. A meeting of the chief district officers of Kathmandu, Lalitpur and Bhaktapur on Wednesday took the decision that prohibitory order in the three districts of the valley would be extended by a week. Prohibitory regulations will further be tightened and no movement will be allowed except for those carrying out essential services. A meeting of Kathmandu Valley's Crisis Management Center had forwarded its recommendations to the Home Administration to continue the regulation that was imposed on August 20 and extended by a week. On Monday, local governments of Kathmandu, Lalitpur and Bhaktapur districts had decided that the offices of local authorities would suspend all their services except for the essential ones till August 31. Keeping in mind the steady rise in the number of COVID-19 cases. Kathmandu Valley currently has the highest number of active coronavirus cases, wherein Kathmandu is the district with the highest number of people undergoing treatment for the disease at present in the Himalayan nation.
Weddings occupy a very important position in the social life of Sri Lankans. Amid the pandemic, Sri Lanka hosted the largest wedding exhibition after the pandemic lockdown in capital Colombo recently. Hundreds of wedding service providers participated in the colourful exhibition. Sri Lanka hosted the largest wedding exhibition after the pandemic lockdown in capital Colombo recently. Hundreds of wedding service providers, including hotels, photographers, beauty experts, caterers, jewelers, clothiers, car rentals, among a variety of others, participated in the colourful exhibition. Due to the effective control of the pandemic by the Sri Lankan government, throngs of bride-to-be and grooms-to-be attended the wedding exhibition, accompanied by relatives and friends. Knowing the importance of the price factor, the exhibitors offered attractive discounts. This is the second wedding exhibition held after the lifting of coronavirus lockdown and is also the longest, stretching over 3 days. The country has so far reported 2,971 coronavirus cases. Weddings occupies a very important position in the social life of Sri Lankans. Sri Lanka has a small number of wedding companies that provide one-stop services, but most families prefer to look for inspiration at wedding exhibitions. Tourists in India's Agra city, the home of iconic Taj Mahal, who wished to see the 17th century monument, were delighted to see it from a nearby viewpoint recently, as the monument remains closed even after 5 months of COVID-19 lockdown.
Tourists in India's northern Agra city, home to the iconic Taj Mahal, were delighted to see the 17th century monument from a nearby viewpoint earlier this week, almost after 5 months of COVID-19 lockdown. Tourists visited the Mehtab Bagh Taj viewpoint, situated on a platform across the river Yamuna, and were seen clicking pictures with the monument at the background. Agra, one of India's first big clusters of the coronavirus, remains the worst affected city in the country's most populous state of Uttar Pradesh.
Actually, जैसे कि coronavirus के time पे ताजमहल वैसे बंद है, but इस time पे जैसे कि मौसम आप देख सकते हैं कितना अच्छा हो चुका है और बारिश की वजह से बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छे level पे पानी बढ़ा हुआ है और ताजमहल का view back side से पहले सूखी पड़ी रहती थी बहुत अच्छा view आ रहा है, so it's good, nice to say it.
India closed many of its tourist sites in March, including the Taj Mahal.
एक्चुअली हम लोग तो फ्रंट गेट के सोच के आए थे कि आगे से खुला होगा ताजमहल पर लेकिन हम इसके बैक गेट पे आए हुए हैं और बैक गेट से इसका व्यू देख रहे हैं तो यमुना जी के स्तर बढ़ने से बस एक ही खासियत ज्यादा अच्छी लग रही है कि ताजमहल बहुत ही सुंदर लग रहा है और देखने में काफी अच्छा व्यू पॉइंट आ रहा है ताजमहल का.
Last month, authorities withdrew a planned reopening of Taj Mahal, citing risk of new coronavirus infections spreading in Agra from visitors flocking to see the monument.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.